Humit English. I am Shaini Day. Let's start today's news.
India reported little over 30,000 new coronavirus cases on Monday. The Daily Health Bulletin said at 32,937, there was a minor dip in new coronavirus cases in comparison with the Sunday numbers. In another sign of receding second wave, the number of active COVID-19 cases have come down to its lowest mark in the last 145 days. The daily COVID deaths also declined to 417 on Monday. At present, India has 381,947 active cases. This is the lowest number of active cases that the country has been since March 2020. However, what remains a cause of concern in the low level of daily testing? The Monday morning, the data by the ICMR source, 11,81,212 corona tests were conducted on Sunday. The daily vaccination drive saw a slump again on Sunday as COVID data shows 17,43,114 COVID jabs administered on Sunday. FE online analysis has shown that India has not seen a high number of vaccine shots given on Sunday. Meanwhile, Union Health Minister Manshukh Mandaviya has reached Kerala as the COVID spike in the state refuses to abate. There is no let up in the surge as Kerala saw nearly 20,000 new COVID-19 infections. This means that the state is seeing more than half of the total cases in the country. If we look at the COVID tally, the cumulative numbers have come down with Sunday recording around 36,000 cases. The national capital Delhi saw zero deaths.
सफलता की शुरुआत सिर्फ मोशन के साथ. मोशन ओपन स्कॉलरशिप टेस्ट फॉर क्लास 7th टू 12th स्टूडेंट गेट अप टू 50% स्कॉलरशिप फॉर सेशन 2021-22 at Durgapur. And for more details, please contact 9434-822.
From our editor Vikas Prasad, Tufan Roy, deputy head of the Adra Gram Panchayat of Purulia district, on the initiative of Purulia district's co-patron chief guest Jay Banerjee, three youngest footballer team of the region played the chief minister dream project on Monday to make hope come true. One football was handed over. It is noteworthy that the Trinamool Congress had created a storm in the election campaign with the slogan Khela Hobe before the assembly election. After coming to power in Bengal for the third time, Honorable Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee announced to celebrate Khela Hobe Day on 16th August. In view of this, courage and enthusiasm was increased by giving football to the youngest team of the players. Football player and the team coaches Rajesh Shankar Chatterjee and Tinku Chakraborty appreciated and thanked to the state government for this innovative initiative of the state government. On the other hand, district commentator Joy Banerjee said that players of all types of Bengal will be benefited by this innovative initiative taken by the state government in the coming days, as well as they will get the direction of their future in this coming years.
যে দুয়ারে সরকারও হচ্ছে, সব জায়গায় বেড়াতে হচ্ছে, মানুষের যদি পশ্চিমবঙ্গ সরকার যা করছে, আর আজকে পশ্চিমবঙ্গ সরকার তথা পশ্চিমবঙ্গ মুখ্যমন্ত্রী তিথি ঘোষণা করছেন আজকে খেলা হবে, সেই জন্য খেলা দিবস আজকে পালন হচ্ছে সারা পশ্চিমবাংলা। এই চারটে খেলা হবে যে যাতে সমস্ত যুবকদের যুবতী তারা যারা খেলাধুলা করে মনটা ভালো হয়, তারা বড় হতে পারে, আগামী দিন নাম করতে পারে, যেন পশ্চিমবাংলার ভালো ভালো আমাদের যেন প্লেয়ার তৈরি হয়, সেই জন্যই আজকে আমরা এই খেলা দিবসটা পালন করছি। এবং পশ্চিমবাংলার যারা যুবক যারা বয়স কম তাদেরকে আমরা বলতে চাইছি যে তোমরা এইভাবে খেলা করো, এই খেলে যাতে তোমরা আগামী দিন জীবনে দাঁড়াতে পারো, এটাই আজকে মহৎ উদ্দেশ্য এবং দিদির অনুপ্রেরণায় আজকে এটা সারা পশ্চিমবাংলা জুড়ে চলে হচ্ছে।
খেলা হবে,
খেলা হবে,
খেলা হবে, খেলা হবে, নেত্রী তোমার নেত্রী মমতা জি জিয়াপ্পা
জিন্দাবাদ জিন্দাবাদ
আমার নেত্রী তোমার নেত্রী মমতা জি জিয়াপ্পা
জিন্দাবাদ জিন্দাবাদ
আমার নেত্রী তোমার নেত্রী মমতা জি জিয়াপ্পা
জিন্দাবাদ জিন্দাবাদ
Fruit traders were involved in an accident while taking a pickup van from Rupnanpur to buy fruits from Asansol on Monday morning. The pickup van hit a trailer parked on National Highway 2. One died on the spot. His name is Avinash. Besides, two others were injured. They are two fruit sellers, Manoj Modi and Rajkumar Modi. Avinash is a resident of Halud Kanali in Jharkhand near Hindustan Gables. Avinash's shop is in Rupnanpur market. On the other hand, Manoj Babu fruit shop is near Hindustan Cables Gate. The incident took place between 3:30 a.m. and 4:45 a.m. today. The incident has cast a shadow of mourning over the Rupnanpur area, especially the market.
Biofina. Drink healthy, stay healthy. Prevention is better than cure. Always cover your mouth and nose while sneezing. Wash your hands regularly. Use sanitizer. Avoid contact with others. Wear mask. Avoid social gathering. Don't touch your eyes and mouth frequently. Issued in public interest by Biofina. Drink healthy, stay healthy. For trade inquiry, mail care@rkmgroup.in. Contact toll free number 1800-258-7060.
The government camp at the door is starting from today. The camp is starting from Jamuria Borough of Asansol Municipality. There will be a 2-day camp in each borough area. Each camp will have 10 counters for Lakshmi Vandar. In addition, the benefits of the other government schemes including the Shastra Sathi, the number of camps in each borough has been increased to 5 from 3 last time. According to administrative sources, camps will be organized at every panchayat, municipality, corporation, BDO and SD office in the district. Special emphasis will be laid on own government schemes like Khadya Sathi, Shastra Sathi, Shikha Sri, Joy Johar, Tapishili Bandhu, Kanna Sri, Rupa Sri, Aika Sri, Jati Sanat. Through these camps, new schemes like Lakshmi Vandar, Student Credit Card, Krishak Bandhu, Free Social Security Scheme, Change of Agricultural Land and Correction of Minor Mistakes in Records, Opening New Bank Account and other related assistance are also available. Beneficiary can apply for these schemes here. The first term of the government at the door will be from 16 August. During the second phase, from 1st September to 15th September, various government schemes from August 16th to take to the people. From door-to-door government schemes is being introduced by the state government. Forms will be provided from 16th August to 15th September. Application will be verified and selected by 23rd September. Beneficiary will be given benefits from 24th to 30th September. A sudden fire broke out in the wires of a power transformer near Punjab National Bank in Bastin Bazar under Asansol Dakshin Police Station. There was a chaos due to the fire. The fire was brought under control by the local shopkeepers. Firefighters had a hard time reaching the spot due to the encroachment, after which they brought the fire under control. Local shopkeepers said that suddenly a spark came out of the short circuit of an electric wire and smoke started coming out as the fire broke out. This caused panic in the market. The local shopkeepers said that due to encroachment, there could be a major accident at the time.
News Movement present YouTube channel for news in Bangla, Urdu, English and Hindi.
Moishila 1 number Colony Ward number 85 Sonali Shibir football ground on behalf of Asansol South Block TMYC a football tournament was organized on the occasion of Khela Diwas. The first game was between Pandaveshwar and Mohishila Colony, in which Mohishila Colony won 2-1. Youth TMC block president Amit Sen said that on the instruction of party supremo Mamata Banerjee, the tournament was organized in all the wards in the Asansol South Assembly constituency. Babita Dash, Bappa Roy, Prahlad Paul, Asis De, Shubal Bauri, Madan Das are present on this occasion. The final of interdepartmental football match was played between Medical Department and Mechanical Power Department of Asansol Division, organized by Eastern Railway Asansol Division at Divisional Railway Stadium, Asansol, on 15 August. 16 teams of Asansol Division took part in this football tournament, which was started on 9 August. Sri Paramanand Sharma, the Divisional Railway Manager Asansol, handed over the winners' prizes to Mechanical Power Department of Asansol Division, who won the match in tiebreaker and becomes the champion. Medical Department team becomes the runner-up. Sri S.K. Munda of DME Power Department becomes the man of the match. At the prize-giving occasion, Sri Sharma, the DRM of Asansol, said that Eastern Railway Asansol Division always encourages sports activity, which in turn increases the working efficiency among the employees. Sri M.K. Meena, ADRM Sri M.K. Mahato, CMS, along with divisional branch officers and a large number of employees were present in the final match as well as the prize-giving ceremony at Divisional Railway Stadium at Asansol.
Like, share and subscribe and forward YouTube channel News Moment. For more details and for advertisement, contact editor 9563830.
As a part of celebration of 75th Independence Day, members of Eastern Railway Women's Welfare Organization Asansol, the President Srimati Anju Sharma, Vice President Srimati Alka Meena, Secretary Srimati Nisha Sinha, along with other members of the organization, visited Bharat Scout and Guide Den at Traffic Colony and Prabhat Tara School at Domohani Railway Colony, and they hosted the national flag. Members of Eastern Railway Women's Welfare Organization Asansol distributed fruits to the indoor patients and the newborn babies of Divisional Railway Hospitals Asansol on 15 August 2021. Asansol Division of Eastern Railway observes 75th Independence Day at DRMA Office Asansol. Sri Paramanand Sharma, Divisional Railway Manager Asansol, unfolded the national flag, scrupulously maintaining social distancing norm and COVID-19 protocols. In his speech, Sri Paramanand Sharma, Divisional Railway Manager Asansol, said that Indian Railways play a very pivotal role in cost-effective transportation of passengers and goods and connecting people from Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from northeast to Gujarat. Asansol Division plays an important role in railway since it is the highest freight loading division of Eastern Railway. However, division is making every possible effort to capitalize in increasing loading. Total earning of this division up to July 21 was 1,327.37 crores, which is 51.90% more than the corresponding period of last year. Asansol Division registered highest earning in ticket checking of ₹1.43 crore, which is highest ever for any July, whereas in July 2019 ticket checking earning was ₹1.10 crore. Punctuality of mail and express trains has touched 96% at the end of July 21, which was 86.45% last year. Passenger amenity is our focus area. Asansol Station received prestigious IGBC Green Railway Station Platinum rating by Confederation of Indian Industries, first time in Eastern Railway. Various energy efficient and environmental friendly measures have been taken by Asansol Division. In this process of achieving the feat, for passengers' comfort, escalators and lifts have been provided in various stations. UTS counter has been commissioned at Katoria and Karjasa stations. Upper class waiting room at Ranigunj station has been re-innovated. One of the finest heritage buildings of Asansol division, namely Burlington, constructed in 1869, has been converted into 30-bedded COVID recovery cum isolation center in a quick time. Out of 29 deaths due to COVID, all 29 settlement cases have been finalized and 21 compassionate ground appointment cases have been approved. A total of 50 compassionate ground appointment cases have been finalized during January to July 2021. In railways working system, the first word is safety and scrutiny, and the last word is always safety and scrutiny. Foolproof safety and scrutiny can be achieved by regular monitoring and alertness of the staff and officers. A short colorful cultural function was presented on the occasion by the Divisional Cultural Association and the members of Bharat Scouts and Guides. Sri Paramanand Sharma, the DRM Asansol, also unfolded the national flag at Scout Dens and Traffic Colony of Bharat Scouts and Guides Asansol District. On the occasion of the death anniversary of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, a rally was taken out in Asansol by the Mandal Committee No. 2, 3 and 4. This day was celebrated by BJP as Save West Bengal Day. The rally started from BJP's Asansol Bazar Party Office located on the site of GT Road. Earlier, all the BJP leaders garlanded the picture of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. After this, a large number of local BJP leaders and workers were present in this rally. This rally started from the BJP party office and went through the municipal corporation till Houghton Road and ended at the BJP office. Through the rally, BJP supporters accused TMC of killing democracy in Bengal. BJP leader and Mandal to President Sudip Chaudhuri has alleged that the law and the order situation in Bengal has collapsed since the result of Bengal assembly election were declared on May 2. He alleged that the TMC government led by Mamata Banerjee is selectively registering false cases against BJP supporters. He said that the opposition is being strangled in Bengal. However, he said that the BJP would not give up so easily, nor would it allow democracy to be killed in the state. The much-awaited organizational change of Trinamool Congress has been announced. The party has entrusted the responsibility on the youth. Former Kulti MLA Ujjwal Chatterjee was made TMC West Bardhaman District Chairman. Barabuni MLA Bidhan Upadhyay has been made TMC District President. Sivdarshan Dasu, the State Secretary, along with Asansol Municipal Coordinator, Durgapur Municipal Corporation Chairman, Mrigendranath Pal has been made the Convener of Durgapur Municipal Corporation, while Kaushik Mandal has been made Youth TMC District President. Minati Adhikari has been made the Oman TMC District President. Rupesh Yadav has been made the President of Raniganj Block.
Like, share and subscribe and forward YouTube channel News Moment. For more details and for advertisement, contact editor 9563830.
A football tournament has been organized here in Rahmatnagar on the event of Khela Hobby Divas in ward number 83. Several teams participate in it, in which Bortoli team was declared winner while Dhanbad team was runner-up. They were awarded trophy on this day. Dignitaries are present: Shahid Parvez, Shama Naz, who is newly elected TMC Mahila President of the ward. Today's SMS of the moment: friendship is the shadow of the evening, which increases with the setting sun of life. To all the viewers, thank you for watching our video. If you like it, then please share, subscribe the video. Don't forget to push the bell icon for further notification.